What's up guys, Johann Frank here. I wanted to do a quick video about the current, as of 2024, lineup that Reunion Blues proposes with an emphasis on their brand new Expedition case, as well as the Oxford. There's a lot of cases out there. There's a lot of issues that guitar players come across while on the road, boarding planes, checking in their instruments, and all of that stuff. So I'm gonna kind of cover some of it and what Reunion Blues offers as far as protection for your instruments. And yeah, their new cases are amazing. So let me show you what they got. So this is a testament to Reunion Blues craftsmanship. I've had this Midnight Continental old school case for a long time. Off the top of my head, at least 12 years. It's been around the world many times, at the bottom of planes, on trucks, on tour buses, and this is how it looks. It's carried a variety of different guitars, and I mean, look. It's pretty pristine. I mean, you can see that it's held a lot of axes. But it's incredible. It's in great shape. The stitching is in great shape. And I hope that it serves me for many more years. The only thing I ever had to fix was a rip here. Of course, this is like a backpack material and it's breathable, which means it's not the most sturdy thing. So I just took it to actually a shoe shop and they so this on top of it, and it's been good ever since. It's nice leather, and it's super solid. So this is their Midnight Continental with the aux bucket here, and it was replaced by the Voyager that many of you have, I'm sure, if you're watching this video, where the auxiliary pocket moved from here to here for passports and such. Pockets, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on pockets, as my previous video, same thing, pockets are pockets, you know, they have a nice EVA protection, you put stuff in it, and a story. Another thing that I wanna point out is that these cases are 12 plus years, and look, this is pristine. Why is this? It's just because I always put my guitars with a rag on top, and a story. That's their double gig bag, RBX, and this does not get damaged. You put metal, little strings against any kind of fabric, it will damage it unless you do this. And so I recommend that to everybody. The neck brace is different on the RBX, right? It doesn't have a strap. These do. This is a bit larger. It doesn't move on the Voyager. It doesn't move on the Midnight Continental, smaller strap. And in their new series, this is the Oxford. Quilted chevron, heather gray exterior, beautiful. That thing is classy. That's keyword, classy, absolutely beautiful. This is their small body acoustic, but don't let it fool you. If I take my triple out 18, full size, it actually fits. So initially I got this case for my parlor size guitar and turns out it fits my Martin, which is awesome. So this case has an adjustable neck brace, which is useful because my parlor size guitar probably ends up like here, so I can adjust that down a little bit. I don't know what they did here, but this is extremely rigid, and it's in a good way. Really rigid. It does not have end pins that are removable, but this is more than making up for it, and it kind of ends here. It's really good. This is a bit more flexible, but again, we have a 1-inch thick shock absorbing flexoskeleton. And yeah, these impact panels here are really good. So, and the interior, the weavy Blue Velvet interior, as always, is very superior to many other brands, especially brands that have this material moving around. This stays in place. Which brings me to the brand new Expedition. With their large Sidekick. We'll get to that in a minute. Same Blue Velvet interior. Same panel as the Oxford protection panel here. Now look at this. This is their semi-hollow model, so it's a bit larger, right? This is the electric model, electric semi-hollow. And I needed it because I have a couple big axes that I was trying to fit in the electric. And honestly, and it's my fault, some of the stitching here started, again, I've had this case for 10 years, okay? So it is allowed some wear and tear. And I've put guitars that are just too big for it. So this is what you risk after a while. If you take a case that is not appropriate for, like, a semi-hollow guitar, okay? And you try to close it, eventually it just makes sense. So I got this new case, semi-hollow, and it's gorgeous. It's big. My first order of business was to take my biggest guitar, my precious Metropolitan, and see how it fits. And look at that. This guitar fits nowhere else. It only fits in its custom hard case. But here, room to spare. And I'm finally gonna be able to fly with this thing. To fly and check this thing in, or take it in cabin with no problem. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. The next strap, neck brace rather, is way more adjustable than the Oxford. The Oxford had two little strips. If you rewind the video, this has this monster strip. They were like, you know what? We're not gonna compromise. And it's great because I can put a smaller guitar in it and put my neck strap here, right? Let's just do this. I'll even show you what it does that blew my mind. I took my 5-string bass. Look at that. 5-string bass fits in the semi-hollow Expedition comfortably. Comfortably, I'm not even stretching anything here. For 5-string bass, so this is a very polyvalent case in terms of size to begin with. And then the adjustable end pins, you can move them as you see fit. So for example, when I travel with the bass, I'll put them on the side. Okay, because obviously it's larger for semi-hollow. My bass is narrower, okay, so I don't do that. And then for smaller axes, if I really want to take the Sidekick, for example, I'll put them at the bottom and it'll lift it up a little bit and I'll adjust the neck strap down and it'll be fine. Actually, I'll try it. This is one of my trusty Strats in the Expedition. The end pins are positioned at the bottom. The neck brace is all the way at the bottom, and there you go, it fits great. Room to spare, but I mean, if you've got more stuff you want to put in and whatnot, it's awesome. So really the polyvalence of this size I had not really thought of before, and it's awesome because it fits my bass, it fits my biggest electric guitars, and it fits my smaller electric guitars with no problem. Even fits my Go Down Grand Concert nylon string. And again, the Go Down is thicker, but this size allows for it no problem. And I'm not gonna risk, again, wearing the stitches eventually here because of a wrong case for a wrong size guitar. Other than that, they have redesigned the zero-G palm contoured handled with weight distributing foam. It's thinner. It's actually thinner than the Voyager, and I get a better grip out of it. This was a little bulky. So that is a new design here. The Oxford has it as well. The Oxford is actually narrow here, but a bit taller here. But all in all, it's awesome. These straps, of course, detach, slide it in here. For the Expedition, it has a zipper but also can slide in here. I found myself even put a show shirt in here or charts, last minute paper charts. It's actually pretty convenient. Same metro handle here. And then it's readopted the passport pocket, I call it, because that's where it goes, from the Voyager here. Great piece of gear. And of course, the Sidekick. That's their biggest innovation here. For Reunion Blues, that is. And this is their large Sidekick. And it, I mean, more than doubles the space that their initial pocket here would hold. It actually fits my on-the-go hot tone silver Ampero right here. Now, a couple of things about this Sidekick. I wish the sides were a bit more rigid. It's basically a backpack. It does not have the EVA rigidity that you find, you know, here, for example, or that you find back here, or even that you find, well, this is about comparable, but it will bend like this if you don't pack it, which is good for storage, I guess. But basically, I would not put super precious things here necessarily. But when you fly, you need space for a water bottle, you need space for sunglasses and, you know, other things, and that's perfect for it. Also, another point, this is the first time I was carrying a guitar like this with a pocket on top. Guess what? It shifts the balance of the X. So it will pull a bit more on your shoulders at the top. And, you know, if you put, I don't know, 10 pounds or 15 pounds of gear in here, I can't think it would be the best thing for the case or for the guitar inside necessarily. So I would keep it as kind of an auxiliary pocket. But I do wish Reunion Blues, if you're listening, that they would add something like this. Is their RBX pedalboard, and there is a rigid panel, especially on top here, that ends here, you see it. If they just added that to the side of the Sidekick, I think it would be great. Another thing is it attaches and detaches with these D-rings, Velcro. Okay, you know, that works. You have to undo them all six every time you remove the thing, and then redo them all six. It's okay. I don't know if there would be better solutions in the future with zippers or things like that, but you know what? It works. And it's a wonderful innovation. And when you put it, I haven't yet, but if you fly with it, you can fly it as is, and it doesn't count as your carry-on. So you can sneak in more things, especially for quick flight dates where you don't necessarily want to check in the luggage. So, amazing new line by Reunion Blues. New logo, updated. That thing is awesome. And again, I wanna put an emphasis on the size, the semi-hollow. If you are on a budget, this is expensive for a case. It's a couple more bucks than the Voyager. The Oxford is kind of in the middle between these guys and the RBX, which are cheaper, about $100 cheaper than the Expedition as of 2024. But if you're on a budget, I would say get one badass case. Get this one and get a size that fits your other instruments if you play other instruments and work with other instruments, because that's what I'm gonna do. And I'm gonna, yeah, I'm gonna work this thing to the ground. So there you have it, the Reunion Blues lineup as of 2024, with all their cases over the years. I can testify that they hold the distance. I've had a couple of them for more than a decade and they look great. They are all backed by a tried and true lifetime warranty that I have actually taken them up on, and they always come through. So there you go, I hope this video helps you make a decision as far as what to purchase to protect your instruments. If you like this video, please consider liking and subscribing to my channel. And I'll see you next time.